Attorney General Coakley, give us the brief version of what exactly you've agreed to with Bechtel Parsons, and then we can open it up to phone calls to people that can ask you questions.
Sure, and I know people have questions about this, and I'm happy to try and answer them. You know, to give the short version is difficult, only because, let me say in a very short way, this was a long, expensive project. And when you mention Big Dig in Boston or in the environs, people roll their eyes. And Jim reports on that, and it is it's hard to talk about it because it was so complex. But in a nutshell, when I first came in a year ago, I had three goals. I think my job was to figure out what happened. You know, what were the facts there? Why did this tunnel collapse? How bad are the leaks? What's the extent of what we now have to fix and will have to fix in the future? So that's question number one. The second thing is, what do we do about that once we have the facts? What are the tools we have? Do we indict people? Do we bring civil suits? Do we work with the federal government? All of those things were huge questions. And the third thing was, after we decided what we wanted to do, could we really do it? And so I think I'm very pleased with the result. I know I'm pleased. And I have to say there was an incredible amount of effort with the federal government and the AUSAs over there who worked on this, the engineers, the staff in our office, our special assistant, and frankly, the folks at the companies that we worked with. Everybody understood that this had to get done. And there was a lot of negotiation back and forth. How much money? What would happen? What would the release going to say? And so it was extremely complicated. But I think what we accomplished are a couple of things. Enough money to pay for what's already out of pocket on the tunnel and hopefully to put in a trust fund so that going forward, taxpayers don't have to pay for higher tolls or worry about the safety of the tunnel on a day-to-day basis. I think that we got payments from both companies that are large enough that hurt them. Did we debar them? No, and we can talk about all this stuff. But I think
debar means, for those who don't know, they can't do business anymore, either in the state or the federal government.
So we can talk about that.
Which,
I'm happy to
by
do
the
that.
Way, it might have led to their bankruptcy.
Potentially.
And if they were bankrupt, would we be getting the $450 million?
No, we wouldn't. And so all of these things we balanced. We also were able to get them to agree to, in the event of a catastrophic event, be able to go back to get more money. And also they made extensive changes in corporate compliance agreements. So people will say, as Jim has, I know, well, they bought their way out of an indictment. It's much more complicated than that. Because in the end, in Massachusetts, I could have charged them with manslaughter. They could walk into court and pay a $1,000 fine. And we would have accomplished none of the above. All of which, I think, are goals of the criminal justice system, which we were able to better accomplish through the civil system and this negotiation.